Hi, this is Scott Haskins in Chicago for the annual meeting of the American Institute for Conservation. I'm going to show you some interesting art-related things that I saw on this trip. I think you'll find it interesting. Let's start by taking a look at the downtown architecture. Wow! We got an up-close look on a river cruise that was guided by an amazing docent who had the answers and the details. She knew everything. She had an encyclopedic memory of the details of every building in downtown Chicago. I was mesmerized by the varying styles and beautiful shapes and reflections in the evening sun. It was really a beautiful, beautiful tour. There is no way that I can remember the names and uses of these buildings, but I hope you enjoy the quick look at these buildings and put it on your list of things to do. If you have a chance to take the tour in the evening with the sun setting, then you get the beautiful light from the evening, and then you get also the city lights coming on. It's great. Though built later, I was amazed that this building was designed in 1921. Okay, let's move along to the Art Institute of Chicago, one of the best museums in the world. Wow, this medieval panel on the life of Christ is amazing. It was made in northern Spain, and it's a treasure to see. This altarpiece was commissioned by Pedro Lopez de Ayala, and as was often done, he had himself and his family painted into the picture. This painting was done in 1396, 100 years before Columbus. This fantastic painting of St. George slaying the dragon is also Spanish and was painted in 1434. What was unique and super interesting about this painting was that the artist sculpted the gesso or the plaster before painting it to give it a three-dimensional effect. Here's a photo of the sensational painting before it went through a recent restoration. And this is a photo of it after conservation. These beautifully carved wooden sculptures were once brightly colored, gilt, and decorated. But imagine what they've been through over the last 700 years. Here's another before and after photo of a 700-year-old painting. Wow, look at those beautiful colors restored. I was very surprised at the beauty of this painting. It is so delicious, mamma mia. It's like a little jewel. What a thrill to get an up-close look at it. On display with the medieval artwork was the weaponry that's 700 years old. During the conference that I'm attending, the art conservators that worked on preserving and restoring this beautiful ceramic relief gave a presentation on taking it apart and creating a new mounting system for this exhibition. Very interesting. One of my favorite artists of the Italian Baroque period is Tintoretto. I posted a video about his home in Venice and the work that he did, which you can watch if you click on the link in the description area below this video. I'm at the Old Stock Exchange, which is located here at the Art Institute. It's kind of cool to see. Here's a quick honorable mention for some Roman art that really grabbed me. As I turned a corner, I immediately recognized this well-known 2,000-year-old face. I've been reading the memoirs of Marcus Aurelius, the greatest Roman emperor at the height of its power. To look into this realistic face and read his words reminds me of the common human experience that transcends the millennia and shows me that we are all spiritual beings having a human experience. This marble goat looked hungry. And the realism of these sculptures, these faces, the expressions, the personalities looked like they were going to speak to me. Like the sculptures, these funerary masks transmit to us the expressions and the personalities of 2,000 years ago. All right, now we're going on a truly insider look at the back rooms of the Art Institute of Chicago to look at the conservation labs and the storage areas of the collections.
We're in the conservation lab. These are washing tanks. Stereo binocular microscope. Incredible quilt.
Okay, well, Mrs. Sturman was here for...
This is the storage area for textiles of the museum.
With images and a proper inventory of the material.
It's interesting that they have a space below the cabinets in case there's water, and there are also spaces between the drawers so that there's air circulation.
Seeing these storage areas with row after row and room after room of museum quality beautiful objects, in this case textiles, and to see them properly stored and cared for it is really a thrill. They've renamed this quilt the quilt that makes people cry, because collectors come in and people that know quilts, and I guess it reduces them to tears. This is funny. Somebody in the past has used hammocks to store textiles, but I don't think they like them nowadays.
So they call this the sexy storage space.
Okay, and here we go. More cool storage areas and great items to look at. Very fun. Okay, so here we wrap up our visit, looking at a custom box that's used to store away fragile items. Thanks for coming on this little tour with me. There are so many other things here at the Institute that are of exceptional quality, iconic, totally recognizable, even famous, but sadly we haven't had time to look at them all.
My visit to Chicago's been great. I hope you've enjoyed these few highlights.